students, today we are going to study chemistry subject for the chapter so called as aliphatic hydrocarbon, and this is session number 6. So we are going to study a new topic over here, and the name of the topic is addition of HX. What is the meaning of the word HX? H stand for hydrogen, X stand for halide, right? So here addition of HX will be going to take place towards the olefin or towards the alkene, right, by applying a rule called as Markovnikov rule. So this Markovnikov rule, you people have been already studied in your 12th standard. Now what this says, that we are going to study in more detail over here, how this addition of hydrogen halide will be going to take place towards a reactant so called as olefin, that we need to understand over here. Okay, now let's understand this Markovnikov rule in more detail, and then we'll take the examples one by one. Okay, so how this Markovnikov rule will be applicable, let's see over here. So let's write down certain statement about the Markovnikov rule. Now what does this Markovnikov rule says? That when an unsymmetrical when an unsymmetrical reagent when an unsymmetrical reagent now what do you understand by the word unsymmetrical? Unsymmetrical means two atoms into that particular molecule will be differing with each other. They are not going to get, you know, similar with each other. Like suppose if I take hydrogen, this is a symmetrical molecule, right? Means here two similar atom will be there. Suppose if I took like this HCl, now this is considered to be the unsymmetrical molecule, because here one hydrogen is there and one chlorine is there. But the most important thing over here is that one atom will be highly electropositive, where the another atom will be highly electronegative. The electronegative species will try to grab or pull the electron density towards itself. So the chlorine being highly electronegative, it will try to pull the electron density towards itself, and thereby it will have partial negative charge, and the hydrogen will carry partial positive charge, so which is called as a polar molecule, right? Where it says that whenever a highly electronegative species is combined to certain atom, that highly electronegative species will try to pull the electron density towards itself, and thereby acquiring partial negative charge upon its surface, where the other species will carry partial positive charge. Right, so that is the meaning of the word unsymmetrical, right? So here what is happening over here, children, is that whenever an unsymmetrical reagent like this HCl or HBr, now what is this HBr or HCl? It is basically HX only, no? It is an hydrogen halide, right? Wherein one halogen group is there and one hydrogen group is there, right? So this is the example of hydrogen halide. So hydrogen halide is considered to be an unsymmetrical reagent, right? So when this type of unsymmetrical reagent is treated with unsymmetrical, is treated with whom? Unsymmetrical alkene or olefin, that time the negative group or part of unsymmetrical reagent will get attached to that unsaturated carbon atom carbon atom of whom? Of alkene. First, let's write down this statement, then I'll make you understand in more precise way over here. So, the negative group of unsymmetrical reagent will get attached to that unsaturated carbon atom of alkene, which carries lesser number of hydrogen atom. Okay, let's understand this statement now. What this statement says? See, when an unsymmetrical reagent, now you understood what is the meaning of the word unsymmetrical reagent, okay? When this kind of an unsymmetrical reagent is getting attached, to whom? An alkene, okay? So let's understand this statement, then we'll take one example. That time it will be more precisely understandable over here, there, okay? When an unsymmetrical reagent is treated with unsymmetrical alkene, now here the unsymmetrical alkene should be there. Now what do you understand by the word unsymmetrical alkene? Here also between double, you know, carbon-carbon double bond, the number of carbon atoms should be different. For example, if I took like this CH3, CH2. So this is what? This is the propene, right? Which is unsymmetrical. So this one, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Yeah, this is a propene wherein it is considered to be the unsymmetrical one. Why? Because across the carbon-carbon double bond, here the double bond is present between carbon number 1 and carbon number 2. So across the carbon number 1 and carbon number 2, the number of carbon atom is not same. The number of carbon atoms are not same. Right? The groups are different from each other. So thereby it is considered to be unsymmetrical alkene. So here children, you need to understand there the unsymmetrical reagent has to get added to the unsymmetrical alkene only, right? So when this is a case which is arising when an unsymmetrical reagent is getting attached to unsymmetrical alkene, that time what happens is that the negative terminal, now which is a negative terminal? Yes, obviously chlorine. Why? Because chlorine being most electronegative species, it will try to pull the electron density towards itself and thereby it will acquire negative charge. And the hydrogen will acquire the positive charge, partial positive charge. So the negative group of the unsymmetrical reagent, so here the negative group, of unsymmetrical reagent will go and get attached to which carbon atom? Will go and get attached to unsaturated carbon atom of an alkene which is containing lesser number of hydrogen atom, right? So this negative part of the reagent will go and get attached to that carbon atom across the carbon-carbon double bond which is carrying lesser number of hydrogen atom over here. So here this between carbon number 1 and carbon number 2, which carbon will carry lesser amount of hydrogen atom over there? Yes, obviously, carbon number 1 is having 2 hydrogen, whereas carbon number 2 is having how many hydrogen? 1, right? Carbon number 1 is having 2 hydrogen, carbon number 2 is having 1 hydrogen. So this negative terminal of unsymmetrical reagent will go and get attached to that carbon atom which is carrying lesser number of hydrogen atom. That carbon atom which is carrying lesser number of hydrogen atom, right? So here, this carbon number 2 will carry this negative terminal of the unsymmetrical reagent. Okay, let's take an example. This was just the assumption with basic example I took. We'll take certain few examples, then you guys will understand more precisely over here, right? So what is the statement is saying is that whenever any unsymmetrical reagent is getting reacted or treated with unsymmetrical alkene, that time the negative group, the negative part or the negative ion which is attached to that particular unsymmetrical region, that will go and get attached to unsaturated carbon atom of an alkene which is carrying lesser number of hydrogen atom, which is carrying lesser number of hydrogen atoms, so which is called as Markovnikov rule. That is basically the Markovnikov rule. And we'll take the example, and which product which has been formed over here by application of Markovnikov rule, that product is considered to be the major product. Let's understand that by taking an examples. So example number one, example number one. Now here we'll take an alkene, so called as propene, simpler one again. Okay, so this is propene. Basically prop one in, okay, because it is present between carbon number one and carbon number two. What is present between carbon number one and carbon number two? Yes, in means double bond, okay. So here when the unsymmetrical alkene is treated with an unsymmetrical reagent which is hydrogen bromide, where hydrogen carries partial positive charge, wherein the bromide carries partial negative charge. So according to the Markovnikov rule, the negative terminal, the negative group of unsymmetrical reagent will go and get attached to that carbon atom in an alkene which is containing lesser number of hydrogen atom. Now the double bond is present between carbon number one and carbon number two. Now carbon number one is having two hydrogen, whereas carbon number two is having one hydrogen. So this negative terminal, negative group of unsymmetrical reagent will go and get attached to that carbon atom which is having lesser number of hydrogen atom, right? So this bromide ion will go and get attached to the carbon number two, because carbon number two is having only one hydrogen, wherein carbon number one is having two hydrogen. Okay, so thereby this negative bromide ion will go and get attached to carbon number two. So after getting going and getting attached over there, the product so formed is as such: CH3CH, okay, one hydrogen gone and got attached, sorry, bromide ion gone and got attached to carbon number two, bromide ion. Then if bromide ion is going and getting attached to the carbon number two, the bond has to break. Otherwise, the valence will not going to get satisfied, because we know that each carbon atom can attach only to the four different groups, because it has a valency called as four, because it has a four electron in its outermost shell, right? So this, once this bromide ion is going and getting attached to the carbon number two, the bond has to break between the carbon number one and the carbon number two. So thereby we are going to get, now this two hydrogen is there, this H plus hydrogen atom will go and get attached to the carbon number one, okay. The negative terminal of unsymmetrical reagent will go and get attached to that carbon atom which is having lesser number of hydrogen atom. So it gone there and got attached to carbon number two. What about the hydrogen atom? This hydrogen atom will go towards the first carbon. So here the carbon atom which is having more number of hydrogen atom, carbon number one is having more number of hydrogen atom, so this hydrogen atom is also going and attaching to the carbon number one. So here rich become richer in terms of hydrogen atom. I repeat once again, carbon number one and carbon number two, if you compare, carbon number one is having two hydrogen, carbon number two is having how much hydrogen? One hydrogen, right? So this towards carbon number two, bromide gone and got attached, wherein the remaining hydrogen will go and get attached to the carbon number one. Obviously hydrogen will not going to remain in a monoatomic form, yes, it will be remaining unstable. So thereby this hydrogen will go and get attached to the carbon number one, though already it has a large number of hydrogen atom which is two. So here rich become richer in terms of hydrogen atom, okay. So this is how the reaction will be going to take place. So this hydrogen will go and get attached to the carbon number 1, which is already having 2 hydrogen. So totally it become 3 hydrogen. Okay, so the name of this product so called it has formed is 1, 2, 3, 2-bromo, IUPAC name I am writing, 2-bromo propane. Why propane? Because parent alkene, number of carbon atom in the longest chain is 3, so it becomes propane, 2-bromo propane. And this 2-bromo propane is considered to be a major product, to be a major product with 80%, with 80%. Okay, the minor product will be the opposite. Minor product will be the opposite in such a way that, now here in carbon number 2, bromide ion gone and got attached to the carbon number 2. So there, instead of bromide ion, hydrogen atom will go and get attached over there, right? So it is opposite. Minor product will be the opposite. Okay, since in first product, negative terminal gone and got attached to carbon number 2, whereas hydrogen atom gone and got attached to carbon number 1. So here it will be the reverse. The reverse condition will be there, that this hydrogen will go and get attached to the carbon number 2, whereas in carbon number 1, the bromide ion will be there, bromide atom will be there, right? So the name of this will be 1-bromopropane. 1-bromo. Why 1-bromopropane? Because if you just number in this way, so this will be attached to the first carbon. 1-bromopropane. Or you can also write down the common name so called as propyl bromide, because it is an alkyl halide. Okay, so 1-bromopropane with minor product. It is a minor product. The minor product will be exactly reverse of that of major product. How you form the major product? Exactly reverse you need to write down for the minor product, which will be, obviously it will be only 20%. 20%. Okay, so this is how the Markovnikov rule will be applicable. So in terms of hydrogen atom, you have to remember, in terms of hydrogen atoms, the carbon atom which is having more number of hydrogen atom, there the hydrogen atom will go and get attached. So that time it's just the thing wherein I remembered is that rich become richer in terms of hydrogen atom in Markovnikov rules, right? So negative terminal will obviously go towards that carbon atom which is having lesser number of hydrogen atom. Okay, now let's take the another example, the second example, by adapting certain alkene to understand the Markovnikov rule in more detail over here. So the second example wherein I'm going to consider over here is isobutylene. Okay, now what do you understand by the word isobutylene? Let's take that. Now CH3 CH2. Now iso means what? Remember children, at carbon number 2, at carbon number 2, the methyl group will be going to get attached. Okay, now suppose this is carbon number 1, carbon number 2, carbon number 3. So at carbon number 2, this is carbon number 2, methyl group will be going to get attached. So this becomes iso, but the name is butylene. Butylene in the sense, the alkene group should be there, right? So butylene means, as per the parent alkane, 4 carbon should present. So if you understand 1, 2, 3, 4, so totally you have to consider this methyl group as also the part of the longest chain, right? So when you are writing the common name in terms of iso, so it becomes isobutylene. 4 carbon will be there, right? When you are considering iso as a prefix, that time you have to consider the methyl group which has been attached to the carbon number 2, that also you need to count down. Okay, wherein the common name for this will be, since at carbon number 2 the methyl group is attached, the IUPAC name, this was the common name, the IUPAC name will be 2-methyl. Now the longest chain is this with 3 carbon, and in is there, means alkene is there, right? So which in means which alkene member with a 3 carbon number atom will be, it will be basically propene. Propene. Okay, 2-methylpropene. Okay, so when this 2-methylpropene or isobutylene is treated with unsymmetrical reagent, so called as hydrogen bromide, which contain partial positive charge and partial negative charge upon the bromide ion, so that time how this Markovnikov rule will be applicable, which was saying the negative terminal, the negative group of unsymmetrical reagent will go and get attached to that carbon atom, unsaturated carbon atom, which is having lesser number of hydrogen atom. Now the double bond is present between this carbon number 2 and carbon number 3. Okay, let's take this carbon number 2 and carbon number 3, but I'll just take in this manner 1, 2, 3, because alkene we are starting from the back side, so lowest preference we need to take. Okay, so this will be carbon number 1 and carbon number 2 if the in is present between them, and as per the Markovnikov rule, the negative terminal, the negative group of the reagent will go and get attached to that unsaturated carbon atom which is carrying lesser number of hydrogen atom. Now, carbon number 1 is carrying 2 hydrogen atom. Carbon number 2, it doesn't carry any hydrogen atom, because at carbon number 2, the methyl group is attached. So, no hydrogen atom is present at the carbon number 2. So, here this negative terminal or negative group of unsymmetrical reagent will go and get attached to that carbon atom which is having lesser number of hydrogen atom. So this bromide ion will go and get attached to the carbon number 2. Remember children, the reaction will going to take place between the carbon-carbon double bond. You are not supposed to touch this carbon. Okay, so once it is going and getting attached over there, the bond has to break, because the valence will not going to get satisfied. So the product will be going to get formed in this manner, wherein the Br will go and get attached to carbon number 2, and yes, where this hydrogen will go? The hydrogen will go towards that carbon atom which is having more number of hydrogen atom, right? So it will go and get attached to this carbon number 1. So this will become CH3. So what is the name of this product so called as? The common name for this product is tertiary butyl bromide. Tertiary butyl bromide, or else the IUPAC nomenclature for this is 1, 2, 3. So at second position, methyl group and bromo group is there. So you can write down 2-bromo, 2-methyl, yes, parent alkene is propane, right? So this becomes the common name is tertiary butyl bromide. Let's see IUPAC name. If you write down common name also, that's more than enough. So this is considered to be the 80% product, which is the major product, whereas the minor product will be there in such a way that it will be the reverse. Reverse means what will happen here? This negative terminal is there, no? It will go and get attached to carbon number 1, okay? Whereas this hydrogen will go and get attached to carbon number 2, right? So whatever the product you have been formed in Markovnikov rule, exactly reverse you have to write down in the minor product, okay? So which is considered to be the 20%, but the name of this is, methyl group I missed out. Methyl group I'll write down here. Yes, methyl group is also there, no? The second carbon. So the name of this is 2-methyl, right? Or 1-bromo. First you need to write down this 1-bromo, 2-methyl propane. This becomes the IUPAC name. This becomes the IUPAC name wherein you guys are studying from since from your PU level, right? So the name for this becomes 1, 2, right? So 1-bromo, 2-methylpropane. Okay, or the common name is will be there isopropyl bromide. Iso, why iso? Here at second carbon methyl group is there. Whenever at second carbon methyl group is there, that time you can add the word iso. So isopropyl, why propyl? Because this is the alkyl halide, right? So isopropyl bromide, you can write down, which is 20%, a minor product. So this is how the Markovnikov rule will be going to take place. Remember, whenever any unsymmetrical reagent is added to any unsymmetrical is very very important, okay, unsymmetrical alkene, that time negative part means the halo group of reagent will go and get attached to the unsaturated carbon atom which is carrying lesser number of hydrogen atom, right? So which is having the carbon which is having lesser number of hydrogen atom, there that negative terminal will go and get attached, whereas the hydrogen which is left, it will go and get attached to that carbon which is having more number of hydrogen atoms. So here rich become richer in terms of hydrogen. Okay, so the carbon which is having already more number of hydrogen, there that the hydrogen is going and getting attached. Okay, so this is how the Markovnikov rule is applicable. Okay children, now we'll talk about the next rule, which is anti-Markovnikov rule, or it is also called as Karsh rule or peroxide effect. So anti-Markovnikov rule, peroxide effect or Karsh rule is nothing but it is exactly contrasting to that of Markovnikov rule. So whatever we studied the statement and took the example for the Markovnikov rule, exactly opposite will be that of anti-Markovnikov rule, right? So let's understand by taking the statement and obviously by taking certain examples, okay? So let's take an statement first. So here, when an unsymmetrical reagent is treated with an unsymmetrical alkene, that time what will happen? The negative terminal or negative group of reagent will attach to that unsaturated carbon of alkene which carries. Now here the most important statement over here, till here the statement was same. When an unsymmetrical reagent is treated with an unsymmetrical alkene, that time the negative group of reagent will attach to that carbon atom, that unsaturated carbon atom, which carries more number of hydrogen atom in the anti-Markovnikov rule. Wherein in Markovnikov rule we studied, there the negative terminal of reagent will go and get attached to that carbon atom which is having lesser number of hydrogen atom, right? But here it will be exactly opposite, right? So the negative terminal of the reagent will go and get attached to that carbon atom which is having more number of hydrogen atom, which carries more number of hydrogen atom. Okay, now whatever the statement was there in Markovnikov rule, exactly opposite will be and a Markovnikov rule. Okay, so let's take an example. Here the example will be as such. Propene, we'll take the simpler one first. So when this propene, which is an symmetrical alkane, when it was treated with unsymmetrical reagent, which is having partial negative charge on the Br and partial positive charge. Why this is there? Because of difference in electronegativity between the hydrogen atom and the bromine atom. Okay, so this here, what will happen is that the negative group of reagent will go and get attached to that carbon atom which is having more number of hydrogen atom. Now here, between carbon number 1 and carbon number 2, which carbon is having more number of hydrogen atom, towards that carbon the negative terminal will go and get attached towards it. Okay, so between carbon number 1 and carbon number 2, carbon number 1 is having 2 hydrogen, wherein carbon number 2 is having 1 hydrogen, right? So this bromide ion will go and get attached to carbon number 1, okay, according to anti-Markovnikov rule, or it is also called as peroxide effect. Okay, so this Br will go and get attached to this CH2, and the hydrogen will go and get attached to CH, obviously, because the hydrogen will not going to remain in a monoatomic form. Okay, so that time that hydrogen will go and get shift towards the carbon number 2, right? So here the product formation will be there in such a way, CH3 CH2 and then CH2 Br. okay, so the name of this product will be propyl bromide, is a common name, or the IUPAC name will be bromopropane. Okay, so here this product will be considered to be the 80% product, which is the major product. Okay, then minor product will be the exactly opposite of it. In minor product, what will happen? It's very simple. So whatever the anti-Markovnikov rule is there, exactly opposite you have to write down in the minor product. Okay, so CH3 CH. Now here at carbon number 2, the hydrogen was going and attach, so that time here the Br will going to come in minor product and this will become CH3. okay, so the name of this product is isopropyl bromide. Okay, or the name will be as such, 2-bromopropane. Okay, which is considered to be the minor product with 20% product formation. Okay, minor product. So this is how the anti-Markovnikov rule will be going to take place, which is exactly opposite that of the Markovnikov rule. In Markovnikov rule, the negative part or the negative group of reagent was going and getting attached to that carbon atom which is having lesser number of hydrogen atom, wherein in anti-Markovnik, the negative terminal of the reagent will go and get attached to that carbon atom which is having more number of hydrogen atom. That's it. Okay, so this is how the reaction is going to take place with the help of anti-Markovnikov rule. So remember children, anti-Markovnikov rule is also considered to be the Karsh rule or the peroxide effect also. Okay children, now let's take the another example, the second example which is applicable for the anti-Markovnikov rule. So let's take the second alkene, which will be the same one which we took in the Markovnikov rule, that is isobutylene, right? So here the iso means what? At second carbon atom the methyl group should present. Okay, now butylene word is there means double bond should be there. So this is how 1 2 3 4, right? 4 carbon atom with iso prefix in the starting point, and this name will be butylene, isobutylene. Or what is the IUPAC name for this? 2-methyl Yes. The parent alkene. Now alkene is there. Why? Because it's double bond is there, right? So it is 2-methylpropene. So this is the IUPAC name for this reactant. Wherein the second reactant wherein we are going to use over here is unsymmetrical reagent, which is hydrogen bromide, the hydrogen halide. Okay, so here the hydrogen will carry positive charge, partial positive charge, whereas the bromide ion will carry the partial negative charge. Now this reaction is taking place in presence of peroxide H2O2. Therefore it is also called as a peroxide effect. Okay, now according to the anti-Markovnikov rule, yes, the negative terminal on the negative group of the reagent will go and get attached to that carbon atom which is having more number of hydrogen atom. So between carbon number 1 and carbon number 2, who is having more number of hydrogen atom? Obviously the carbon number 1 will have more number of hydrogen atom, because at carbon number 2 no hydrogen atom is there, right? So here the reaction will take place between carbon-carbon double bond. Remember, never touch the carbon atom where the double bond will be not there. Unsaturated carbon, okay? So these are the unsaturated carbon atoms, right? So here the negative terminal of the reagent will go and get attached to that carbon atom which is having more number of hydrogen atom, right? So this will go and get attached to this red carbon number 1. So the product will be going to get formed in this manner. CH3 will be going to get remain undisturbed, the bond will be going to get broke over here, and this becomes CH2Br. Negative terminal will go and get attached to carbon number 1. What about the carbon number 2? This hydrogen will go and get attached to carbon number 2. Okay, so the product which has been formed over here by application of anti-Markovnikov rule, the name of this product will be as such 2-methyl-C. 1, 2, right? So this will be, okay, first we need to write down the bromo group is also there, right? So 1 bromo, 2-methyl, parent alkene, 3 carbon is there, no? Parent, you know, in the long form straight chain, 3 carbon is there, right? So it will be propane. Or the common name for this is isopropyl bromide, right? This is a second carbon methyl group, right? So iso, why? Because at second carbon methyl is there, but this 3 carbon chain is alkyl, this is halide. So isopropyl alkyl halide, okay, isopropyl halide. So the halide was bromide, so isopropyl bromide. So the name of this product as such I had written with the IUPAC nomenclature, and it will be considered to be 80%, which is a major product. Okay, now what about the minor product? Whatever the product has been formed over here, exactly opposite you need to write down for that. Okay, so the minor product will be as such CH3. Okay, now here the Br was going and getting attached to carbon number 1. So instead, in minor product, this Br will go and get attached to carbon number 2. Opposite, reverse. So it will go and get attached to carbon number 2, the negative part. Whereas the remaining thing will be remaining as it is. This hydrogen will go towards the carbon number 1. So whatever you have written in the major product, the minor product will be going to get obtained in reverse manner. Okay, so the name of this is tertiary butyl bromide. That is the common name, tertiary butyl bromide. Or the IUPAC name, if you want to write down, you need to write in this manner: 2-bromo, 2-methyl, then the parent chain is propane. Wherein the IUPAC name is in this manner, wherein the common name for this is tertiary butyl bromide. This is 20%, which is a minor product, okay? So this is the minor product. So this is how the anti-Markovnikov rule will be going to take place, which is exactly opposite that of the Markovnikov rule. Anti means against. Anti means against. So against Markovnikov rule, the opposite one is anti-Markovnikov rule, peroxide effect or Kasch effect. These are the two alternative names for that. Okay. So children, we have been winded up with this two important topic, which are very, very contrasting to each other and very, very important from examination point of view as well. So we are winding up with the session number 6. Now session number 7, we will begin with the new reactions, new preparation or, you know, methodology of reaction, chemical reactions we are going to study over here. So until that time, thank you class for watching this class. Thank you so much.